I'm Martin Sargent. Clearly, I'm the guy. Duh. I'm pretty much the man. Get with it. Yo, what's up? That's rad, man. What's up? I've never seen anything like that. Blingo? Blingo? I'm screwed. Unscrewed, the show that is not afraid to cry. I'm Martin Sargent. The Switch is sitting over there. What up, Switch?
Well, Martin, I just noticed you're wearing brown again. I'm wearing brown. I feel like we're trying
up
to be twins.
Up here and down here. Brown.
What?
Hey, you know what I haven't done in a really long time?
Kissed a girl?
No, that's not true. I'm getting mad play. I host a TV show. You don't think I get all the breezies? They're all over this fine piece of man.
Really?
It's been a good 8 months. I'm exaggerating. Frankly, I don't even remember it. I was so screwed up. But what I was going to say is, what we haven't done is the unscrewed news in, like, forever.
Wow.
And the fact is that all those people wrote in were like, dude, what's with the news? It kind of sucks. That's the real reason. But some stories are just too important not to be told. So let's get to it. Maybe you read this first story on Slashdot or somewhere. This is Microsoft announced recently that it would offer free downloads of thousands of e-books in an attempt to bolster the use of its MS Reader program, which I think it's great. Thanks to Microsoft, I now have the choice of not reading literature in book form or not reading it in electronic form.
Options, choices.
Yeah,
that's
reading's
what it's
not
about.
Cool anymore. But Microsoft, you silly bastards, you know everyone is just waiting to download the pirated version of the movie anyway. You with the times. So I saw this other interesting story. USA Today reported that 60% of summer camps nowadays have banned...
Boned?
Yeah. You know how they do it. Those scout leaders.
Very progressive.
Scout leaders. No, what they've done is they've banned cell phones this year because they say that cell phones interfere with camp life.
Huh.
Now, capitalizing on this situation, Mother Nature announced that she will no longer be offering free night and weekend minutes on smoke signals.
You know, I think I know the real reason.
Obviously, I did not know the real reason.
The real reason they're boning cell phones at camp these days. Now, the reason they're banning camps is because the kids keep calling their parents up. Hey, you want to get home? Remember when you were at camp, you had to write the letter?
They're beating up on me again. So it's the parents. They're
the
behind
parents,
this.
They don't want their
they're
kids.
Like, hey, we got rid of those.
That's
in
why
two
they're
weeks.
At camp.
All right, we got time for one more. Unfortunately, we do. All right, happy birthday, Intel. Happy birthday, Intel. That's right, Intel, the great Silicon Valley computer chip maker, celebrated its 35th birthday recently. And at the party, Intel founder Gordon Moore got wildly drunk, kept going up to all the female employees going, you want Intel inside? You want Intel inside, baby? And that's a crappy little piece of our world tonight.
You know, the sad thing is, I heard he actually got some play with that line.
Done by the night, because that was less than 8 months ago. All right, hey, tonight's show is smoking. Not to say that smoking is good. In fact, it may be dangerous to pregnant women. Anyway, sure, there's Spider-Man and Daredevil and all the X-Men, you know those guys, but they're all fake. Tonight, we've got a real-life superhero, Mr. Elastic, is going to be here tonight. And our girl gone wired is a well-known model. You may have seen her posing in panties in a Fredericks of Hollywood catalog that was addressed to your sister, but you snagged it from the mailbox. Plus, go from bland to wham with the Unscrewed Makeover team. They'll be making their debut tonight. Now, you know me, man. I'm a lover. I'm not a hater. And I do my best to foster good international relations by inviting foreign dignitaries onto my show. Well, finally, one of them said yes. Welcome, His Excellency, the President of Malaysia. How you doing?
I'm very well. How are you?
I'm great. So let's start with some of the basic facts here. Pardon my geographical ignorance. Where's Malaysia?
Well, you know, it might come as a surprise, but Malaysia is very close. We're right here in the United States.
Yeah.
You didn't know there was a country right here in the United States.
There it is right there. How big is Malaysia?
That's Government House. That's our flag flying in front of Government House. We're about 35 miles east of Reno.
So, okay, you're landlocked in Nevada.
Very landlocked. No Navy here.
You ever cross the border for some gambling or legal prostitution?
We try to avoid that. It's an ugly place.
Yeah, I see that you've got some various buildings over there in Malaysian land. You've got a general store, a railroad station, a post office, but they all look very tiny,
very tiny. That's our railroad. And that's actually a model railroad out behind Government House.
So, I mean, are the people there very small? Is it like midget land or something like that?
They're about 2 inches tall.
Yeah.
Wow.
What's the population of Malassia?
The actual population of Malassia is just four.
Just four?
We're a very small country, and we couldn't fit very many more folks in this country than that.
Are they friendly folk?
Well, mostly. They're family.
This is your family. So basically what you have here is a country on about 1 acre of land, and you seceded from the United States.
Well, secede is kind of an ugly word. We just sort of came into being, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
It was kind of an idea that I had with a friend of mine when I was about 16 years old, and that's 26 years ago now, and we're still going strong. Bigger and better every day.
Hey, if I wanted to visit Malassia, would I need shots or like anti-diarrhea medication?
Hey, what kind of place do you think this is?
I just, you know.
But a passport would be good. You know, a nifty little stamp, we'll stamp it for you.
Is Malassia recognized by anyone except for yourself, Your Excellency? Like the United Nations, do they recognize this? Like Kofi Annan or anyone like that?
No, actually, the bigger nations tend to ignore small nations like Malassia. Because Malassia is in the United States, that might make the United States government mad if, say, Germany started recognizing little countries inside the U.S.
Do you pay taxes to the United States government?
Absolutely. It's called foreign tribute, though.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I heard that the Malassian Ministry for Space Exploration just bought a new telescope. That's kind of exciting.
It was. It was great. We could see the moon now without squinting. It's really, really nice. Then we shot off a couple rockets. We're trying to take an aerial picture of Malassia. That hasn't really... Now, with great success lately.
How much of the budget did you sink into this telescope?
It was about $30.
Yeah, yeah. That's great. Are there a lot of these other micronations out there?
Absolutely. Micronationalism is a really, really big hobby for folks that are on the internet. It tends to be focused heavily on young teenage males,
mm-hmm.
Before they find girls.
Yeah.
And after they find girls, they forget all about it. But it doesn't take much to start. Get a free website through GeoCities or Tripods.
Start your own nation. That's great. Do you have diplomatic relations with these other nations?
Yes, actually. I have pretty strong relations with some that are out here in the West. In fact, right there you see Queen Casey of Torhaven. They're actually down in the Los Angeles area.
Uh-huh.
And then we have some really good friends over in Denmark, the Prince of Corvinia.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some other ones.
Do you guys have, like, a sports league? You compete in volleyball or something like that?
You know what? We actually did the Olympics a couple years ago during the Sydney Games. We had Olympics where each nation would go out and do their own thing, like run, and then come back and report however fast they ran. And then we gave out medals. It was just pretty nifty until the Olympic Committee got mad at us for using the logo.
Have you gone nuclear yet?
No. I get mad every now and again. Does that count?
That counts. Hey, Your Excellency, best of luck to you and all your good people, and keep it real over there in Malassia.
Well, thank you.
The Malassian National Anthem, everyone. Check out malassia.org or go to techtv.com/unscrewed, where we've got the hookup to those fine people in Malassia. Now, coming up next, stretch the boundaries of what it means to be human with Mr. Elastic. But first, tonight's musical guest, a whole gaggle of my favorite people, they've come together for this little ditty. Hit it, fellas.
Unleashed, Monday through Thursday night at 12, and back-to-back episodes every Friday night beginning at 11, only on Tech TV.
Hey, welcome back. So our next guest can bend his lower limbs in a way that would make any yoga master boil with envy. He's been called a freak boy and a class clown, but officially, he goes by the moniker Mr. Elastic. Please welcome Moses Lanham. Hey, Moses.
Hi, Rob Martin.
So what exactly is Mr. Elastic able to do?
Mr. Elastic has the very unique, one-of-a-kind ability of turning his feet around backwards and then walking.
Let's see it. Can you do it right here?
Sure, let's
start out with the trick. Turning his feet around backwards and walking. All right, let's get the camera down there. Oh, boy. Oh. Jeez.
Oh.
Oh, man. No! That's disgusting, man. What the hell are you doing? What is it about your body that, like, permits this thing?
I have got extra ligaments and cartilage within the joints of my ankles, my knees, and my hips that allows my bones, the joints, to rotate within their sockets painlessly and freely.
You're on morphine right now.
Oh, no, I'm not.
How did you discover that you had this talent?
When I was in middle school, I was 14, and they had an activity in gym class where a rope was hanging from the ceiling. You climb up the rope, you touch the ceiling, and you come back down.
I discovered a lot about myself climbing the rope as well, Moses. But go on.
When I got about 15 foot up off the ground, I lost my grip, and when I fell, my feet were tangled up underneath me. Now, my gym teacher and some other classmates had thought I either dislocated a joint or broke a bone or whatever. I stood right up, my feet went right
up. You landed like that.
Yeah.
What do you think? I mean, this is such freaky. Do you think you were, like, bit by a radioactive tapeworm at some point in your life or something?
No, I thought I was very gifted. So I started testing my flexibility to see what all I could do.
But you don't consider yourself a contortionist. Like, why not? Why aren't you, like, what separates you from, say, like, this guy here, or this woman? So that's pretty crazy. Or like this guy here. What's the difference?
The majority of contortionists usually have to dislocate joints for them to be able to bend them way. Like you've seen the most common of a gentleman or a person fold themselves up and put them into a glass box.
Yeah, it's a good pal.
They've dislocated like their kneecap or they've dislocated their shoulder. I don't dislocate anything. All mine is natural.
Have you ever been contacted by the circus or anything to perform?
Jim Rose, Sideshow, did
that. Yeah, you should do that.
Mm-hmm.
They've got guys who hang like cinder blocks from their ding-dongs on that circus. You know that?
I know.
Good company.
That's
up
painful.
There. Have you ever met anyone with the same ability?
No. I do have a 10-year-old son that can do the same
You're
thing.
You're kidding me. It's genetic.
Right.
That's awesome, man.
Did you put this on now?
Do you guys, like, fight crime?
Do we Mr. Elastic and Son?
Yeah.
No, not yet. We just make a lot of people laugh.
Okay, but you got a website. You decided to put a website out. Mm-hmm. Has the internet affected your ability to get bookings? I mean, are you making a living off this
now? The internet is my agent.
Yeah?
I prefer not to have a actual agent because that way I can decide what I want to do, when I want to do it, and so forth and so on.
So you're making money off
so
of this.
Yes. I put my website
We're not paying you a damn cent. You know that, right?
The food's good.
So you've been invited to a lot of appearances through the internet and everything. Mm-hmm. That's your agent. That's a great story, man. So can you teach Laura how to do this, maybe?
I can try.
All right. So Mr. Elastic is now going to teach Laura how to do something terribly freaky. And you probably don't want to see it. Okay,
let's try something simple.
Okay.
Just 1 foot. Turn it like that. Oh, that's pretty good.
Oh, wait. You know what I'm going to do? Here we go.
Clam digging. All right.
Now can you do this?
No
Cross
problem.
Your legs. Go toe to toe.
You. Please be careful, Laura. Oh.
Yeah.
Moses, you should wear like big red clown shoes when you do this. That would make it a lot more impressive. Oh my God. Oh, look, he's all the way back.
See
the feet are all the way backwards. Oh, I wish the lighting was better, but they're all the way back.
You lost
disgusting,
me right
there. Man. It's disgusting. Moses. Thank you so much for being here. Laura, did you get it? Is that it? You can't do it. No one can do that. But Moses Lanham. Hey, if you want more information on Mr. Elastic's talent, or if you want to book him for your bar mitzvah, birthday party, whatever, check out his website. Links can be found at techtv.com/unscrewed. I can't believe it. Hey, Porn Mom Judy is back with another tip for your surfing pleasure. But before that, here's the musical guest, the musical stew. Can you guys take us to break, please? Judy and another porn tip of the day.
Hi, it's
just meet Judy with your porn tip of the day. Watching those dirty downloads in the window the size of a postage stamp is just a darn waste. Even a hottie like Jenna Jameson is going to end up looking like George Washington, and nobody wants that. So those of you who use Windows Media Player, I've got a tip. Here's what you do. If you want to see your actors in all their full screen glory, hit the Alt and Enter key at the same time. And presto, full screen mode. Woo! Those are really large. And remember, hitting Alt and Enter only takes one hand, and that's always a plus. That's it for today. Don't forget to keep sending me your tips at judy@techtv.com. Bye for now.
She's good at what she does. Now, clearly I need some fashion advice, and Laura, you were going to help me out try to update my image, right?
Well, actually, what I said was I was going to try and make you a little less handsome and more...
Come again?
You know, more...
I'm not sure. I don't know what that means, Laura. I don't know what that means.
It's pretty obvious. It means that I found a really good site that teaches you how to do-it-yourself heavy metal makeovers.
Heavy metal makeovers. Now you're talking.
Exactly.
I like that. I want to be more Sabbath, man.
More
I want to be Sabbath.
More
How does this thing work?
Well, it's very easy. You just go to the site, and they supply pictures or faces that you can use or not. Now, I wanted to use my own, so I uploaded a very special picture of Martha Stewart because, well, I feel that Martha Stewart is in a little bit of trouble, might be going to jail
She's
soon.
She's given us so much fashion advice, it's time for us to give something back.
Exactly. And
yeah.
So I figure
That's not bad. I like the little hat. The little hat really works on her.
I tried to stretch that one out a bit, but
and
yeah,
also
I think it does.
The studded collar. That's hot,
studded
Martha.
Collar
I really like
and,
that. Anyone else?
Well, yeah, actually, John Ashcroft.
All right, the Attorney General.
He's
not really the coolest looking guy in the world.
Cool.
A little conservative.
A little
vanilla.
Conservative, a little creepy, and I think it's hard for people to be spied on by him looking the way he does, but with a heavy metal makeover, he might look like this.
Or he might look like a Captain Morgan Spice rum commercial. Or the captain was here. He could have done a little bit better than that, but we started this out because you wanted to help me. What have you done for me?
Right. It's always about you. I took a picture of you and played around with it, and I think you're going to like the results. See?
That sucks.
No. It's the
that really sucks. It's like that Sex Pistols guy in like the height of the heroin overdose. They look terrible.
What I wanted to do was accent your lobe. You've got wonderful ears, and I think it's a shame that you don't share it with the world.
No, that whole thing is a damn shame, Laura. Thanks a lot.
You know what? If you think you can do a better job, then go to the site, and you can do that by visiting our site, techtv.com/unscrewed.
All right. Thanks a lot, Laura.
You're welcome,
Good
Martin.
Attempt, anyway. Hey, now it's time to connect your browser to the erotic side of the net. Here's Girls Gone Wired. Oh, yeah. Tonight's babe was born singing. In fact, she used to lay in her crib and sing herself to sleep. What demon possessed Yvette Nelson's freaky child's body? I know not. But at the tender age of 8, she formed a band with neighborhood kids and went house to house singing for candy. They say that's how Halloween was invented. At 16, her family moved to California, and she was discovered at a mall by a modeling agency. Modeling put music in the back seat and Yvette on the front cover of such magazines as Vogue, Cosmo, and Elle. But 3 years ago, something amazing happened. She meditated in her garage and felt lost without purpose in life. Hopefully, the car wasn't running. And then she started to talk to God. The next thing she remembered, Yvette walked upstairs and ran into an old friend who was a music engineer. And from that point on, music was once again the center of her life. A spooky yet inspiring story from tonight's Girl Gone Wired, Yvette Nelson. Hey, casts are not just for broken bones, people. They're for perfectly functioning bones as well. We'll show you what we mean after the break. But now, this video displays yet another compelling reason you should get broadband already.
Well, viewers, we've granted your wish.
Turn to Tech TV for the best in gaming, gadgets, and fun. Let Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb show you how to turn it on. X-Play, tonight at 11:30, only on Tech TV.
SmackDown screwed. You know, if it weren't for the internet, I'd think I was one seriously messed up Mother Hubbard. Well, with all the hang-ups and obsessions and all, I'd probably be in therapy. But the internet has taught me everyone is insane, and this insanity has inspired a bit we call the Fancy Fetish of the Week. You know, I remember when I was in the seventh grade and had the biggest crush on Jodi Pitts, but every time I would try to talk to her, she would run away. Just run away like the wind, calling me booger face. Then to my extreme joy and wonderment, my prayers were answered. Jodi fell off of a grain silo and broke her leg in four places. She could run from me no longer. It was at this point in my life that I started getting turned on by women in casts, just like the good people at the website castfetish.com. When Jodi came back to school, her leg was wrapped in a glorious husk of white plaster. It shone from her wheelchair like a Greek pillar outside Aphrodite's temple. In no time, all the other school children started using magic markers to write good wishes on Jody's cast. All I wanted to write was, Jodi, don't sock me with your cast system. I ain't no untouchable. I even tried hitting my own shin with a hammer so I could get a cast and we could hobble together as one. But then Stewie Radonna ran me over with his El Camino while I was doing my paper route. He didn't stop, so he got arrested for hit and run because I knew it was him. And it turned out he was high on dope. I didn't even break my leg. But I got a blood clot and had to miss 5 weeks of school. I met lots of crippled girls in the ER, and I never thought about that broken hoe Jodi Pitts again. And that's my story.
It's gonna be
okay.
Nice
memory. Yeah, hey, if you like Girls in Cats and you want to see more, watch Chicago Hope or get a link at techtv.com/unscrewed. That's all we got time for. Did you miss a show this week? Well, you can catch your entire week's worth of Unscrewed every Saturday, 10 p.m. or 1 a.m. Eastern, or just watch tonight's episode again at 2 a.m. Eastern. You got nothing better to do. You may as well. Hey, I want to thank our guests, our friends, the president of Malasia and Mr. Elastic, but most of all, you good people for watching. Please keep watching. Good night.
I walks up in the club, and the ladies looking lovely, tried to show some love, but the gators tried to mug me, walk up to the bar, and I tried to get my drink on, step on my feet, if you wanna get bang on, oh, no. Yo, great!